Hello and welcome, students. My name is Mr. Namaswa. I'm taking you through longitudes and latitudes. Before we start, I want to remind you to register and log in to the website. I've sent a link to our subgroups where you'll be able to click on the link. It will take you to a Google form where you are required to enter your full names and your admission number for me to confirm your attendance so that I know those who are present and those who are not. I'll give you 1 or 2 minutes to finish that process. All right, so today is our second lesson on longitudes and latitudes. And there are a number of issues I would like to clarify before we can do some questions. Now, as you can see, we want to look at distance along great circle and small circle. In the previous lesson, we said all longitudes are great circles. And we said all latitudes are small circles apart from the equator. All right, so all longitudes pass through the north and south pole, and therefore they are great circles. But latitudes are small circles apart from the equator. So let me just remind you of what we mean by longitude and latitude. Here is my Earth, which is a sphere. We have the GMT line that passes from the North Pole to the South Pole. Then we have the equator, which is the latitude that runs from the east or to the west. So this side is the west and this side is the east. Then we say the longitudes run perpendicular to the equator, passing through the North Pole and South Pole. Those are longitudes. Then the latitudes, remember they are complete circles. So it goes and comes the other side. Then we have another one here, which is a complete circle, that is a latitude. Then we have other latitudes towards the north. And there's a smaller one as we go up. So we are saying these ones, which are longitudes, are great circles, while these ones here are latitudes. They are perpendicular to the axis of the Earth, and they are small circles apart from the equator. Now, when we identify or when we want to locate the position of a place on the Earth, it could be a city, it could be a village, we position it depending with the latitude and the longitude. For instance, if this is our latitude 60 degrees north. Why is it north? Because it is up the equator towards the North Pole. So any latitude above the equator is north. Then this down here, because they are towards the south, we could have 30 degrees south. So if we want to locate a point here, for instance, we'll call it point A, we are looking at the latitude on which it lies and the longitude. So this longitude here could be 80 degrees. This is east. While a point here, let's call it point B, which is right here, this is latitude 30 degrees south, And on which longitude? 80. The longitude is the same. Longitude 80 degrees, as you can see. Now, you can be asked to find distance along the longitude. So you'll be looking at the distance along a great circle. Or you could have a question asking you to find the distance along the latitude, which would be distance along a small circle. Now, back to your Form 2 knowledge. You know, when you talk about areas of sectors, you learned about the arc length. We'll apply the same knowledge here. When you want to look at the arc length, what do we look for? We are saying an arc is a part of a circumference. And since we know the formula for finding circumference to be 2 pi r, so when we look for the arc length, which is the same as now distance along either a great or a small circle, we'll be applying the formula theta over 360 times the circumference, which is 2 pi r. Now, we have the radius of the Earth, which is approximately 6,370 kilometers. Then, the individual latitudes could have their own radii that will be given or we'll be able to find out. So, if you want to find distance along a great circle, how do you go about it? Distance along a great circle. So we want to find the distance along a great circle. And this is our globe, our Earth. And we have the equator and the GMT. Then we have that, and we have that longitude. So, let's assume we have a point on this part here, which I'll call point P, and its position is 70 degrees north and 80 degrees east. Then we have another point, let's say here, which is a point Q, and its position, it's on the same latitude, so it is 70 degrees north, but it's towards the west, and it's on longitude, let's say 60 degrees west. So they share the latitude, but the longitudes are different. One is on longitude 80 degrees east, and the other one is on longitude 60 degrees west. And we are told, find the distance between point P and Q. We want to find the distance between those points. That is one. Two, we have another point, which we'll call R, that is on this position, here. So R is at latitude 40 degrees south and 80 degrees east. All right? Then, We want to find the distance, calculate the distance between arc PR. Find the distance between arc PR. That one there. Then the first part, you want that. So class, as you can see clearly, the first part of the equation, we are told to find the distance between point P and Q. P is here and Q is here. This one is what? It's a latitude and it is not the equator. So if you want to find the arc length, the distance PQ, we are talking about distance along a small circle. All right? I'll tell you how to derive the formula for finding that. Then the second part of our equation, we are told to find the distance between arc PR. P is on longitude 80 degrees east, and R is also on longitude 80 degrees east, but latitude 70 degrees north and 40 degrees south. So if you look at now the distance between point P and R, we are told to find the distance along a great circle. Why? Because PR is on a longitude, but PQ is along a latitude. So how do we find, how do we work out that? Now, we have been told the radius of the Earth is 6,370 kilometers. So, if this is our equator, then it means that is the center. So the radius here is 6,370 kilometers. But if we talk about this latitude here, its radius is not equivalent to the radius of the Earth. It will be a smaller radius. So how do we find a small r? We are not given that. I'll use this illustration to show you how to do that. Okay, I have that, then so you can see from my diagram here, from this is the center of the Earth, this is the radius of the Earth, and since this one is a longitude, it means R is also the radius of the Earth, this big R. Then this is our latitude. All right, this is our latitude up here. Let's say that is 70 degrees. So if you are told that is 70 degrees, latitude 70, that means this one here is 70 degrees. Now, we have this angle here. We have that angle there. This R and the big R, this one is also radius, are parallel, and this one here is a transversal, meaning this angle here is also 70 degrees, and this one here is the radius. So how do we find this R? By Sokatoa, You have this angle here. This is the hypotenuse side, and this is the adjacent side. How do you find R? When you have, we want the adjacent side, and you also have the hypotenuse side. Which trigonometric identity of Sokatoa do we use? You have adjacent and hypotenuse. We use what? Cos. So we'll say cos 70 is equals to adjacent, which is R, over hypotenuse, which is big R. And that means if we cross multiply, we'll have now R is equals to big R times cos 70. So this 70 could be any angle. So the general formula now for finding the radius of any latitude will be given by small r is equals to big R cos theta, assuming theta is the angle subtended at the center. So now with this one, you can be able to solve the first question. You are told to find the distance between point P and Q. And here are the values that you are given. So, since we know the formula, now we can go ahead to work out. So we want to find the distance between P and Q. Now, in the previous lesson, we talked about angular distance, and we said if our points are on different or on opposite sides, one is to the east, the other one is to the west, what do we do to find the angle subtended? We said we add. So, for us to find that, remember, we say theta over 360 times 2 pi r. 2 pi r being the circumference. Remember, all latitudes are circular. So when we want to find distance between two points on the latitude, we are simply looking at the angle that is subtended by the two points at the center of the latitude, then times the circumference of a circle. And this will be given by theta. We now take 60 plus 80. Because one is east, the other one is west. The angular distance, we add them. Divide by 360 times 2 times pi, and pi is 22 over 7 times small r. And small r, we have said, is equals to big R times cos theta. So we have times r, which is the the radius of the earth, 6370. Times cos 70, which is our alpha here. And this will give us 60 plus 80, we'll have 140, divide by 360 times 2 times 22 over 7 times 6370 times cosine of 70, and that will give us 9,861.5 kilometers. 9,861.5 kilometers, and that now becomes the distance between point P and Q, which is distance along a small circle. Right, you can copy that before we go to working out the second part of the equation, which is now telling us to find the distance between points on a great circle. Point P and R are on the same longitude, along longitude 80 degrees east. How do we find the distance between them? All right, so part two now, we'll say distance
between P and R is distance along a great circle. So by great circle, the radius that we'll be using is the radius of the Earth, which is 6,370. Therefore, theta over 360 times 2 pi r, and our theta now, so this is what we are doing. The center, the equator is here, the center is here. So we are joining that point to this point here. And this one here is 40 degrees. So this one is 40 degrees south, and this one here is 70 degrees. 70 degrees. So because one is north and the other one is south, this one is north and this one is south, they are on different or on opposite sides of the equator. How do we get the angular distance? We add the two. Therefore, theta will be 70 plus 40, which is 110 degrees. Then R is 70 kilometers. Therefore, we have now 110 divided by 360 times 2, pi is 22 over 7 times 70. What does that give us? Okay, let's see. Divide by 360 times 2 times 22 over 7 times 6370. And that gives us 12,234.4 kilometers. 12,234 kilometers. So that becomes the distance between points P, which is on a longitude 8 degrees east, and point R, which is on longitude 8 degrees east and latitude 40 degrees south. Because both are longitudes, then we say we are finding the distance along a great circle. Now, I want to do one final example, then I'll give you some work to do. I'll give you one more question to give you more practice on how to find the distance along a small or a great circle. Now, as you can see on the screen, there's a question there. You're told, calculate the shortest distance between point X, which is 40 degrees north, 80 degrees west, and point Y, which is 40 degrees north, 100 degrees east in kilometers, taking pi to be 7 over 22, and the radius of the Earth is 6,371 kilometers. And you are told to give your answer to the nearest whole number. All right, welcome. Now the first step is for you to sketch the globe so that you can be able to plot the relative positions of point X and Y. So, don't get tired of drawing these sketches. They'll help you simplify your work. Okay, so that is my sketch. This is the equator, which is 0 degrees. Then we have latitude up there. We have another latitude down here. So this one here is the equator.
So we are told point X is 40 degrees north, 80 degrees west. So my north is up here, my west is to my left, and my south is down here. So when you are told latitude 40 degrees, let's say this is the latitude that we are talking about, 40 degrees north. Then we are told 80 degrees west. So 40 degrees and 80 degrees west, this one here is longitude 80 degrees west. So my point X is actually here.
Use a different pen.
So this one becomes my point X. Okay, so X is 40 degrees. Remember I said that when we give those coordinates, we start with the latitude, then the longitude. So 40 degrees north, because we are going towards the north. So the longitude, 40 degrees north is this one. Then west, 80 degrees is here. This side here is our west. So point X is here. Then point Y is 40 degrees north, meaning it's on the same latitude, but 100 degrees east. So towards the east, we are moving this direction. So if I can have an extra longitude, there I have it. Yes, this is longitude 100 degrees east. So point Y is on this latitude, but on this longitude. There is my point Y.
All right, so what is the question asking? Calculate the shortest distance. The shortest distance. So I want this distance here, which is an arc on this small circle. That distance. So this latitude, the center is here, and therefore that will be my radius. Then it is subtending this angle here. That is my radius. So the angle subtended by that arc, which is XY, is this angle here. And as you can see, point X is 80 degrees west, which is this side, while Y is 100 degrees east. What does that tell you? They are on opposite sides of the axis. So how do we get the angular distance? We add the two. So we'll say now, theta will be 100 plus 80 degrees, which will give us 180 degrees. That is the angle subtended by the two points. Then R will be given by the big R cos alpha, which will give us, we are told to use 6371 times cos alpha is going to be the latitude angle, which is 40 degrees. So our R is going to be what? Let's see, 6371 times cos 40, and that gives us
4,000. 4,249.1 kilometer. Ignore the sign. Then this now is our radius of that latitude there. So we want the distance between X and Y. So distance, which is an arc length, is given by theta, which is 180, divided by 360 times 2 times pi, 22 over 7, and the small r, which is 4,249.1 kilometers. And by calculation, this is what we'll have. 180 over 360 is the same as a half, times 2 times 22 divided by 7, then times 49.1, and that gives us a distance of 13,354.3 kilometers. You are told what? Give your answer to the nearest whole number. So that becomes 13,354, because 3 is less than 5, and therefore it could not round off upwards. So those are 3 questions that can help you do practice on how to answer questions on distance along a small circle and along a great circle. We'll stop there for today. You'll find a link on your WhatsApp group that will lead you to a Google form where you'll find some questions on these aspects we have learned today. Thank you, and have a good day.